Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel and lovely greetings out of an actual Airbus A320 cockpit. Today we'll be looking at this little thing right here, and I'm sure many of you have seen this before and have asked yourself, what is it good for? So let's get right to it.
South 1383, runway 27, clear to take off. United 1538, number 327.
Big thank you to Videoblocks who are sponsoring today's video. They are giving you guys a 7-day free trial for all their footage, and their aviation related videos are absolutely amazing. Watch until the end to see a little bit more about it. Now, this little thing is no switch, it's not lit up, and it doesn't move. What you see here is the eye position indicator. Little but very important. Okay, imagine this. You get into your cockpit and you sit down in your appropriate seat. As you gently let your left hand hang down towards the floor, you can reach these two switches, with which the cockpit seat in the Airbus can electrically be adjusted in its horizontal and vertical axes. A little lower, you have the levers to manually adjust the seat and backrest. So as you adjust your seat, you keep your eyes on the eye positioning indicator and either rise or lower your seat so that the red ball is in line with the white ball behind it. You then have the correct seating position regarding your viewing angle, meaning that 50% of your peripheral vision is covering the instruments, such as the PFD, the primary flight display, and the ND, the navigation display, and then the other 50% are covering the outside. Still, your eyes would have to refocus from the instruments to the outside, but you wouldn't have to move your head during the scan. If you were to sit too low or too high, you would have to move your head up and down to see the instruments or the outside, and either position would significantly reduce your visual segment. Especially during low visibility approaches, the correct seating position is very important. Besides now having the right position regarding your viewing angle, you are now also in the correct spot to reach all the flight relevant switches from your seat. Next step is to adjust the outboard armrest. This comes down like this, and then your forearm rests comfortably on it as you're holding the side stick. Now, there should be no gaps between your forearm and your armrest. Your wrist shouldn't be bent when holding the side stick, and therefore the armrest can be adjusted accordingly by turning these little wheels below here, and an indicator window shows its current position. Once set, this ensures that you can accomplish flight maneuvers by only moving the wrist instead of lifting the forearm from the armrest. Symptoms of incorrect armrest adjustment include over-controlling and not being able to make small, precise inputs. Next step is then to adjust the rudder pedals at your feet. Your feet must be in a position so that the full rudder deflection can be applied instinctively without delay. At the same time, you need to be able to apply full brake pressure at the top of the pedals using your toes. And again, you have a position indicator so you can memorize that number to use the position on other Airbus models in your fleet. Then you bring down the armrest to your left and then adjust its height so that your forearm rests comfortably on it and your hand lays on the thrust levers. Then you buckle up the seatbelt and shoulder harness and you're more or less ready to go. And by the way, many other airplanes have similar indicators to get the correct seating position. Here's an example of a Bombardier Q400 and of a Boeing 747. I hope you enjoyed this short video about the seating position in an Airbus. Make sure to tune in next Thursday as I'm starting a 10-week Airbus system knowledge video series. And by the way, lovely greetings to Prince Aviation Flight Academy in Belgrade. Big thank you to their performance teacher Ivan Milosevic, who presented my takeoff speeds video to his class. Cheers, Ivan, appreciate it. Wishing you all the best, your Captain Joe. This video was sponsored by Videoblocks. If you are a video creator like I am check out their great website. The link is in the description below, or go to videoblogs.com/future and get an exclusive 7-day free trial. For example, I was searching for a video about the Royal Air Force Red Arrows, so I went to the search box, typed in Red Arrows, and look at how much content there was to choose from, and it's so easy to use. So you'll be seeing this clip in an upcoming video of mine fairly soon. And by the way, Videoblogs has one of the fastest growing and largest stock video libraries with over 3 million videos, after effects and motion backgrounds. This includes the only contributor marketplace that gives 100% of the commission back to the artist. So make sure to check it out.